This week on HomeKit News, the Sequra Smart Doorknob with Thread. Welcome back, everybody. Today we're looking at a smart doorknob with keypad from Holomarq, and as you can see, the lock and keypad are all in one. It works exclusively with Apple Home, and as far as I'm aware, this is the first latch lock with Thread, with Bluetooth if you don't have a Thread border router. The Sequra HK1, as it's known, is a latch bolt lock, and it comes in two finishes currently, with this model being the matte black one, which also comes with a matching black keypad. The other finish is in metallic gold. I'll be installing this one later in the video. As you can see, this model comes with a white keypad, but essentially both function exactly the same. You should be aware that Holomarq make a non-smart version of this lock, the H1, which looks and feels identical to the smart version. So as you can see here, apart from the HomeKit code, they look exactly the same. So do be careful to order the HK1 if you want HomeKit. Additionally, Holomarq also make the H2, which is also a non-smart lock, and once again, it looks almost identical except for the fingerprint sensor mounted on the top of the handle. I've tested this out for a while and the sensor is super fast, so hopefully the HK2 with HomeKit will be with us later this year. So back to the HK1, and let's see what you get in the box. It looks like a lot, but actually this is really easy to install, so don't panic. Alongside the lock, you get a pair of keys, a few guides, and a strike plate, as well as some spare screws for different door depths. Let's now have a look at the features of this lock, which allows up to 50 passcodes. It has a thing called passage mode, which is actually achieved by turning off auto lock mode. There's anti-prying technology, allowing you to add numbers before and after your actual code. It supports HomeKit via Thread, of course. It's IP54 rated, so not quite weatherproof. 1 year battery life is claimed, and emergency power via a USB-C port is offered if your batteries die. Currently, the HK1 is only offered in the two colours you saw earlier, but hopefully they'll be adding space grey and glossy silver at a later date. There's admittedly not a lot to see with this lock, with most of the action on the outer assembly, which features a backlit 11-button rubber keypad, a keyhole for standard keys if required, and a status LED. The handle may look bulky, but actually it's only 2.25 inches wide and tall. The depth of the door lock is just a bit over 3 inches, including the door plate, with handle only measuring just under 2.5 inches. On the subject of size, some have commented on how large it is, but actually when you compare it to the existing handle on this door, for instance, it really is only a little bit deeper. You do initially need to break the lock down into its three components in order to fit it, which are the inner and outer assembly and the latch bolt. But as I already said, installation is very easy. Just be careful when feeding the data cable through the deadbolt latch bolt. I'm going to quickly skate over the installation here, but you do first need to adjust the back set on the latch bolt to either 60 or 70 millimeters, which is easy enough. This installation should take you less than 5 minutes in my opinion, but for a more detailed installation video, click on the link in the description. Do note that even though I'm using a powered screwdriver here, it's advisable to tighten all screws by hand to avoid any potential issues. With the lock installed and moving freely, I just need to connect the data cable and install the 4 AA batteries. Before closing the door, do make sure the backup keys are with you when testing the lock, but as you can see, the lock will open by pressing the confirm button on the lock until it's set up in HomeKit. I'm going to use the Sleekpoint app to add it to HomeKit, so when you're ready, make sure to press the reset button until it beeps twice. Once you're ready, you then just scan the QR code and go through the standard HomeKit setup, just like any other HomeKit device. The only difference here is you'll have to set up a main access code. If you already did this with another HomeKit lock, it'll show you the same code that covers all your locks with this feature. So with that in the bag, I just need to refit the cover for the interior assembly, and I'm good to go. Let's now have a quick look at the lock in Apple Home. As standard, I get a single tile for the lock, and if I tap on that tile, I get to the toggle switch and then the settings page. In this page, you get the battery life percentage and a feature called Manage Access. This allows you to add or remove users directly within the Home app if you prefer, although it's sort of basic. If I add a new user now, it'll provide a passcode, although I can change that if I want. I'm adding 85, 85, 85, and as you can see, you'll be warned that the code can be easily guessed, but it's only for testing, so I'll go with it anyway. With that done, I can now share that code if I wish in a variety of ways, including messages and even AirDrop. I'll now just test the lockout, and you can see it's already locked. I'll try it via Apple Home, and it's a little slow at first, but generally it's quite responsive and definitely quicker than Bluetooth. You can also see that after 5 seconds, the HK1 is set to auto lock after 5 seconds by default. Let's hop over to the Sleekpoint app now, and from the main screen you can directly lock or unlock the HK1 or go into a dedicated screen with a large button. At the bottom of the screen is an option called Lock Activity, which shows you all the goings on, including unlock and lock methods, which could be via the phone, keypads or keys. But the logs even show you if someone has turned the handle when it's locked, which is quite handy if you want to know someone is up to no good trying locks whilst you're at work. Back to the settings page, and this allows you to turn a few features on or off, like auto lock, anti-prying and feedback sounds, etc. If we go into auto unlock and turn it off, the app offers to unlock the door for us when setting what is known as passage mode, which is quite useful. With auto lock disabled, which is essentially enabling passage mode, I'll show you that the lock will now not auto lock by default. In fact, if we go into Apple Home, we can still lock the door, but once unlocked again, the passage mode is still active, so locking doesn't reset the lock to auto lock essentially. When it comes to access for users, the Sleekpoint app has much better options than Apple Home. So if I go in and create a new user, I can also tag that person, be they family, friends, a cleaner, or even a delivery person, for example. With each user, you have one of three options for them: unlimited, limited, or one time. In this case, I'll choose limited and enter the passcode. Then I can choose the start and end dates, as well as set time limits for when that code is valid, so between 11 a.m. and 1 p.m. in this example. Finally, I can also set specific days that the code will work on and have these repeat. Unlimited just sets a code with no preconditions, so I won't go into that one. The one-time option allows you to set a one-time passcode for a furniture delivery maybe, and with this option you can still set a range to cover a period of days as well as hours, which is useful if the date they arrive is going to be flexible. So as this uses Thread, it should be faster or at least more consistently responsive than Bluetooth. So I'm first going to test it whilst I'm on my home network. Now you can see that whilst it's not as snappy as you might get with a Zigbee sensor, which is understandable, it's still a lot faster than my experience with Bluetooth. Because it uses Thread, there's no direct connection between the lock and your phone that normally is the case with Bluetooth. So now I'll turn Wi-Fi off and test out what is essentially remote access. Surprisingly enough, it appears to be just as fast. I guess this is the difference between Bluetooth and Thread in a nutshell. The final thing I want to test is the emergency power option. And for this, I'm using a Xiaomi power bank and a USB-A to USB-C cable. I've removed two of the four batteries, so as you can see from my screen, it's showing no response as expected. And you can see that the door is also in the locked state, although standard keys will work, of course. So now I'll just plug the USB-C cable into the port under the lock, which is also connected to the power bank I mentioned before, and immediately the lock comes to life. It still shows us no response at the moment, but you can still use the keypad to gain entry like I'm doing here. You can then put in fresh batteries to get it running normally again. Onto the pros and cons now, and at the risk of sounding like a broken record, anything with Thread is welcome to HomeKit News, and this lock is no exception. The price is very attractive, and although this is probably more suitable for connecting doors like a garage to main home, or possibly a home office, being a Thread latch lock, it's in a class of its own right now. It looks a bit bulky, but it does feel very sturdy at the same time, although no lock is totally beyond damage if someone is determined to get in, but it feels like it'll last a good while. Some people really hated this lock when it was announced, but failed to take into account that the size and shape are essential, as this acts as a doorknob, not a deadbolt, and as you saw earlier, it's actually barely any larger than our standard door handles. Passage mode is quite well thought out on this lock, so it doesn't get turned off when someone locks the door. There are, of course, two large elephants in the room, namely Matter and HomeKeys, but I think it's fair to not expect HomeKey for the low price. Matter is a different thing, and there's no word on when or if an update will happen, but I think it's better to not make promises that may be broken, and as long as it works with HomeKit, I have no complaints. So that's a wrap on the Sequra HK1 from Holomarq. Let me know your thoughts, and if you have any questions or comments, or if I miss something, feel free to ask and I'll always reply. Please do like, share and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And as always, stay safe. And remember, a bad excuse is like fresh fish. It will not stand the test of time.